We joined the Liberian Red Cross, who are responsible for collecting dead bodies throughout the capital city of Monrovia. One mistake can cost any or all of these workers their lives. I spoke to Robert, a member of the burial team. He is one of the heroes in this war. Every day he risks his life, and he's doing it for no payment.
The essence of my being here to work for the Liberian people, the Red Cross, in the war at large, is not to be on payroll. I'm doing this so as to have the particular sickness alleviated from my country. I love my people. See my people dying there, it satisfies me a lot.
A lot of people who are working with Ebola victims or the dead are being stigmatized.
I eat alone at my house.
Yeah.
Girlfriend don't want to visit me. Friends don't want to visit me.
If Ebola is to be beaten, it will owe a lot to the character and selfless service of people like Robert.
This is so detailed, it's so thorough. You know, the way you do everything, take your clothes, how you put them on. It's when people are taking off the PPEs, that's when it's even dangerous. That's how people have caught Ebola.
You have to be very careful in taking off the PPE because it has to do with your life.
Do you get distracted? Do you get tired, you know, from just staying focused?
I was trained to that. So I used to, it has become habitual.
What do you really want to do in future?
Well, I really love to study. I love the medicine area, the medical area. But in Liberia, for a young man like me to get a job now, it's very tedious. It's hard, very, very hard.
What do you think will happen if this Ebola crisis comes to an end and you still haven't got a chance to be employed properly by the Red Cross?
It will be my greatest wish to see other things shall have subsided. And then Red Cross calls me to be one of their employees. I really appreciate it.
Once upon a time, as a young man growing up in Sierra Leone, by the age 9, I was looking after my parents because they were very, very poor. So when I meet someone like you, I understand. I understand and I respect you. And I am a living example that we can come out of poverty. I can see your ma is very old, but you know what? You are making her proud. And I hope, you know, a good man like you get an opportunity to be able to look after your old ma.